Hello friends and viewers, we are back again with a new video and new topic, but one of the most commonest suffered from probably I would say every other human being today, gastritis. Gastritis, as the name itself indicates, gastro means our stomach, itis means inflammation in the stomach, means our stomach, as you all know, is a bag, is a muscular bag which secretes lots of juices, including acids for digesting your food. Whatever food we take in through our mouth, partial mastication or chewing happens in the mouth with saliva being secreted, and which is ready for getting digestion to the next phase in the stomach. Goes through the esophagus, the food pipe in the chest, in between your lungs and the heart, and gets into your stomach, which is just below your rib cage, just behind the rib cage, and below the lungs on the left side of your body. So what exactly happens in gastritis? I would say the reason for gastritis is three important things: hurry, worry, and curry. Means hurry, we are in a rush most of the time, the stress and the demands of our day-to-day life. And excessive worrying and excessive thinking. Even in traditional medicine also it is thought that excessive worrying will impact our gastric secretions. It can increase the gastric secretion or also become deficient as well, depending on each individual. We cannot say exactly what happens. And the third important point is curry, the food what we take in, which is with a lot of spices and extremely strong foods, flavors and artificial ingredients coming into picture in terms of coloring agents or flavoring agents, preservatives and so many and so forth. And also refined foods. So these are all the factors, excessive oil as well. All these factors put together, hurry, worry and curry is the major cause for our gastritis today. And what are the symptoms which happens in our gastritis? First important thing is the heartburn, burning sensation in the chest. At the same time, it can be bloating in the abdomen. And you feel full very quickly after eating. Maybe two morsels of food or two fists of food, you are already full. And you will also feel a lot of burping, flatulence and irritation in the throat. And especially when you lie down after your meal in the night, then you will feel discomfort in the chest. Many a times the gastritis can become so much that it can mimic a heart attack as well. Lot of people go into the hospital with, I have the symptoms of an heart attack, because we all know how heart attack presents these days with lot of information coming along. So when we go and check in the hospital, our ECG will be normal, blood pressure will be fine, and all those things are fine. So gastritis can mimic even a heart attack. So you can imagine what is the extent of discomfort it can cause to you. And what are the long-term effects of gastritis? It will lead to indigestion. In traditional medicine, we would say lead to indigestion and formation of toxins, undigested food matter which starts accumulating in the body, leading to toxemia in the body, and acidic nature in the system increases. So that can be a root cause for constipation, IBS, headaches, and even to that extent that we can low grade inflammation starts from there, which can lead to diabetes, hypertension, cancer, autoimmune conditions, you name it, lot of things can start. Traditional medicine also believes that gut is the major cause for lot of chronic ailments. If you keep your gut good, and you will be able to overcome lot of diseases. And our ancestors have already mentioned that if you know how to eat and how to think rightly, you are devoid of going to any doctor. You can prevent going to any doctor. That's how gastritis has become one of the causes, main causes for several chronic ailments. How do we deal with this? There are two pronged approach which we have to follow when we are managing gastritis. Let me put forth in terms of acupuncture and yoga therapy. I told you about hurry, worry and curry. Curry is something, the food which has to be changed in your day-to-day life. Moderation is very important. Organic food is important. Adequate fluid intake is important. And the right food timings is very, very important. Because of all these factors, the curry aspect in the hurry, worry, curry is managed. how do we tackle with hurry and worry? That is where yoga and acupuncture comes into picture. When it comes to hurry and worry, I would say yoga takes a very good step forward by helping us to practice a lot of asanas, which will help you to release the excessive gassy feeling in the abdomen, make your bowel movements better, your moderation in terms of juices secretion, because your worry is reduced, hurry is reduced. When parasympathetic activity increases by doing asanas and your stress reduces, thereby there is a balance in the gastric secretions as well. Along with that, when we practice pranayamas and relaxation techniques, that will accentuate the effect of parasympathetic activity in our system, thereby again manage to moderate the gastric secretions in our body, thereby reducing the acidic feeling in the system. And balances our digestion. When the digestion is balanced, you, as I told, everything else is balanced automatically. Another important aspect is acupuncture. Acupuncture is based on traditional Chinese medicine. When we say heartburn, bloated abdomen, or constipation, some irritation in my throat, all those aspects in terms of acupuncture tells either the energy, we call it as qi or prana, is rebelling, which is going up, or which is deficient, which is not sufficiently strong enough to digest your food. Just like the flame on the on a stove, on a cooking pan. So what happens if the flame is too low and the vessel is too big? It won't digest. There is deficiency. It will take a lot of time to get digested. Same thing happens with us. When hurry and worry is there, there is deficiency of digestive energies in our body. Automatically, you take a lot of time to digest. That leads to indigestion many a times. And if that hurry is very high, for some people, that rebelling of the qi, rebelling of the prana, which tries to go up, is also a factor which can cause the heartburn, irritation of throat, sometimes headache, dizziness. All these factors come into picture. So that's why acupuncture, when we deal with the treatment of it, we normalize the flow of energy by making the energy flow in the direction it's supposed to flow and prevent the heartburn, and also boost our qi so that digestion becomes better. At the same time, in terms of modern science, when we understand acupuncture, it will release a lot of neurotransmitters and relaxing chemicals in our body, and hormones are balanced. Thereby, our hurry and worry aspect of gastritis is also covered very well, or balanced very well. When that is also balanced, automatically you are taking care of the curry, hurry and worry is taken care by yoga and acupuncture, then automatically you are in the best aspect of managing gastritis. One thing I want to make it very clear here. All these things, many patients will ask us, how long should I keep doing? You have to do as long as you want the effect of it. Answer is not, I have gastritis, I'll go and take an antacid and I eat what I want. That's not the answer. So we have to correct our food habits. We have to manage our stresses. As long as you're managing yourself, you don't need the acupuncture or yoga to be taught or anything. If you are maintaining yourself, you don't need the help of a doctor. But if you cannot do that, obviously you have to take the sessions or the treatment as long as you are not able to maintain by yourself. So there is no timeline for that. But at the same time, you need to be consistent in the taking of the treatment. Apart from that, consistent in the practice of your food habits. As I mentioned, regular timings, organic food, proper adequate intake of water, managing your stress, all those things will become very, very important. And yoga, the important rule in yoga is two important things. Build awareness of your practice, and second thing, be consistent in your practice. If you do that for 3 to 6 months, you will see the changes for yourself. You don't need a justification from anybody else. I hope all these points will motivate you to make sure that your digestion is taken care of very well and gastritis is prevented. If you have any queries, any comments, please post it on our YouTube channel or the comment section. We'll be happy to address your queries and clarifications. Thank you so much for hearing to us.